Hi, Assalamualaikum everyone. So we meet again, okay, on this video. So we will continue on our syllabus, okay, regarding JFET, okay, or the general topic is FET, FET, fake effect transistor. And we have two main devices on FET. The first one is a JFET, and the second one is a MOSFET. Okay, so let's we recall on our previous video. So we have learned and discussed how to draw transfer characteristics, okay, for JFETs, okay, at the n-type and n-channel, okay, sorry, n-channel and p-channels, okay. So today we going to do the analysis, okay, for the JFET circuits, okay, but we focus on fake bias JFETs, okay. So let's move to the next scenes, okay. Now we going to discuss on our FET biasings. Okay, I open the slides here right now, and then okay, this is for introduction. You can read, okay, you can read the point that I've mentioned in the slide. So for the JFETs, we have a relationship between input and output quantities, and then it's linear due to the square term in Shockley equation. And nonlinear function result in curve as obtained for transfer characteristic of JFETs. Okay, they have a nonlinear function. Okay, that you have draw. Okay, in the curve is actually is nonlinear functions. And then a graphical approach. Okay, will be used to examine the DC analysis. Okay, as we all know that the FET also use a DC analysis. Okay, to analyze the circuits, okay. And then the different thing is we have a mathematical approach, and then we have graphical approach, okay. Later on we will discuss about it. And then we have the input of a BJT and FET controlling variable are the current and voltage level. This is a difference, okay, between BJT and FET. Okay, so we going to know about the FET biasing circuits. Okay, so for JFETs, okay, we will cover on three. Okay, for JFET, we will cover on three. Okay, this one three. You can see my figure. Okay, three biasing circuits. Okay, the first one is fake bias. Okay, and then the second one is self bias. The third one is voltage divider bias, okay. Same thing with the BJT, alright. And then for the DMOSFET, we have two biasing circuits, self bias, and the second one is a voltage divider bias. And then for the enhancement MOSFET, we have two bias. The first one is fake configuration bias, and then the second one is a voltage divider bias. Okay, for this video, okay, we will cover only on fake bias circuits, okay, JFETs, and then fake bias circuit only, okay, first one, alright, for this video, alright. So let's continue on the next slide. Okay, this is a general relationship, okay, for the FET, okay, you can see at the first point, okay, you can see my cursor, okay, for all FETs, okay, we have to use IG equal to 0 and ID equal to IS, okay. I recall again, IG equal to 0 and ID equal to IS, okay, for all FET types, okay. At the fake bias, self bias and voltage divider bias, we'll use this condition, okay, assuming that IG equal to 0 ampere and ID equal to IS. And then for JFET and D MOSFET, we will use this equation. Okay, for second point, ID equal to IDSS 1 minus BGS over BP power of 2. And then for E MOSFET, we have a new formula that for ID and then the constant value K and then the desaturation voltage VD saturation equal to BGS minus VT. Okay, everything clear? Alright, so let's move to the next slide. Okay, now we're going to discuss on JFET's fake bias configuration. As we know that the fake bias is same as a BJT bit bias configuration. The arrangement, the circuits, the capacitor, the resistor, is the same thing as a BJT. And then one of the new FET configuration that can be solved using either mathematical and graphic approach. So this fixed bias configuration can be solved by using two approach, okay? Mathematical and graphical approach. Okay, what is mathematical? You will use the formula that ID equal to IDSS in the previous slide. Okay, and then for graphical approach, you will draw the transfer characteristics for that circuits. Okay, and then like BJT, FET, JFET also have DC analysis. So means all capacitors are replaced by an open circuits equivalence. Okay, so for DC analysis, we will ignore all the capacitor, or we will replace the capacitor by open circuits. Means no capacitor for DC analysis. Alright. Okay, so these are the circuits. Okay, we going to use as example. Okay, how to analyze these circuits? Okay, now we have a fake bias configuration circuit for JFET. Consists of RD, RG, and VGG, and then we also have a capacitor C1 and C2, and then we also have input voltage and output voltage. Okay, at the left side and right side. Okay, and then the voltage source we call as VDD. Okay, and then don't forget about the terminal of a JFET. Okay, we have D stand for drain, G stand for gate, S stand for source. Okay, so GDS. Okay, so we will apply the condition that we have I have mentioned in the previous slide, which IG, we assume that IG equal to 0 ampere, and what will happen on when we simplify the circuit is when IG equal to 0, that means when you use the Ohm's law, VRG equal to IGRG, so IG equal to 0, so means the voltage that through the VRG equal to 0, so we will ignore the RG. Okay, so the circuit will be looks like in the right sides. Okay, and then we will do a KVL on that slope, and then what happened? So we have a minus BG, minus BGS equal to 0 when we apply KVL on this loop, and then we only have BGS equal to minus BGG. Okay, so after we got the value of BGG is minus BGG, okay, is actually equal to VGS, we can apply in our formula. Okay, so we already know that we have formula ID equal to IDSS 1 minus BGS over VP power of 2. So we have BGS value, and then we also already know the constant value, which are IDSS and VP. So we can calculate the ID, okay, current through the drain. Okay, oh, okay, sorry. Alright, so we're going to do the, okay, so before that, don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel. This is okay. All right. Okay, so we're going to move to the next slide. So for the equation is actually is a mathematical approach. Okay, so we also have a second approach, means graphical approach. Okay, so by using the shorthand method that we have learned in the previous video, okay, so we have got the point VGS and ID, we calculate the value all the row, and then we can plot on the graph, then we can find the transfer, we can find the transfer characteristics there. Okay, transfer characteristic. Okay, like this, the transfer characteristic. Okay, as you can see in the slide. And then how to find the ID on the transfer characteristics? Okay, we just find the, after we found the BGS value actually equal to minus BGG, okay, by using the KVL, okay, on the previous slide, okay. Okay, this one, okay, by using the KVL, then we found the VGS value, then we can plot on our transfer characteristic graph. Okay, so how to plot is a vertical line. Okay, vertical line for fit bias configuration JFET, we draw the vertical line. Okay, by using the BGSQ equal to minus BG value, so we draw the vertical line, and then we find the intersection between our characteristics, transfer characteristic curve, and the vertical lines. So we have a point there, and then we know that in the current ID axis is our IDQ value. Okay, this is how we find the ID value by using graphical approach. Alright, everything clear? Hopefully everything clear until now. Okay, so this one in the slide you can read. Okay, but I going to do some example one. Okay, example one, let's say we have this fake bias configuration circuit, so you need to determine the VGS value, ID, VDS, VD, VG, and VS. Okay, all right so like this. Okay, okay, we have to find what? VGS, okay, before that we find ID first. Okay, we find ID, we find VDS, we find VD. Okay, can you see? Okay, sorry, my face. I can move my face here, no problem. Okay, so VDS, VD, VG, and VS. Okay, VG and VS. So we have to find all this. Okay, VGS, ID, VDS, VD, VG, and VS. Okay, so where is the VGS? This one, our VGS, positive minus VGS. Okay, can see where our ID? Here is our ID. ID, okay. Where is our VDS? VDS is here. Okay, positive minus VDS. Where our VD? Okay, VD is here. Okay, this one our VD. Okay, where our VG? VG is here. This is our VG. Where our VS? VS is here at the source. Okay. Alright. Okay, so we have to simplify our circuits, okay, by applying. So we already know that our IG equal to 0 amp, and then our VRG actually equal to IGRG. Okay, this one is 0, so our VRG is 0 volt. So here is 0 volt, this one is 0 volt. So 0 volt we can cancel out this one. Okay, we can cancel out. Okay, so what happened on our simplified circuits? Okay, we do the DC analysis here. DC analysis. Okay, for JFET. Okay, hopefully you can see. And then what we have now? Okay, I changed my color. Okay, we have a VDD here. And then we have RD here, and then we have ground here. Okay, this is our D, this is our S source, and then we have our gate, and then this one we remove. So negative, positive, we G. So we have remove our capacitor, okay, open loop, okay, replace all the capacitor by open loop. So means we remove the capacitor, and then our circuits look like this, okay, our circuit look like this. So this is RD, okay. So what we going to do next is, okay, I change my color next. We have to apply KVL at this loop 1 to find VGS. Okay, to find VGS. So this one positive, negative, VGS. Okay, now what we have now is KVL at loop 1. So we have VGG, okay, plus VGS equal to 0. So okay, this one okay, VGS, okay. So now we want to find VGS equal to minus VGG. Okay, so we know that our formula is ID equal to IDSS 1 over what? VGS over VP power of 2. Okay, VGS over VP power of 2. Okay, what so now we have the value of IDSS equal to what? Okay, from the example 1 you can see in the slide IDSS equal to 10 milliamp. Okay, 10 milli. So okay, sorry. Okay, I just move my face here. Okay, now you can see. Okay, sorry. Okay, so this one is 10 milliamp, 1 minus, okay, our VGS, okay, what value of VGS? What value of VGS? Minus VGG. VGG is what? Okay, refer to the slide. VGG is 2. 2 volt. So minus 2 volt. Okay. Minus 2 volt over BP. BP equal to minus A. Okay, minus A. Okay, power of 2. So you can cancel out this one. Okay, so our ID equal to 10 milli 1 minus 2 A power of 2. So you can calculate the value. Okay, please calculate the value. Okay, so I don't want to calculate. I leave the answer to you. Okay, to calculate. Okay, so please find the value. Okay. Okay, now you have to find, you have found the ID. Okay, this one got the ID value. Okay. Okay, BGS okay. BGS okay. ID okay. Okay, now VDS. Okay. So sorry. Okay. Okay, move here. Okay, you can see what I write. Okay, in the middle here. Okay, and then we want to find VDS. Okay, now we want to find VDS. So I will erase first all this thing. Okay, so VDS is this on this loop. We're using this loop. Okay, VDS by using this one is our VDS. By using this loop, same thing BJT. Okay, so okay, VL at loop 2 equal to minus VDS. This one plus minus, so we can change this one. Okay, you can change this one, our VDD. Okay, as usual, like this, positive minus, positive minus, ground, positive minus, this our VDD. Okay, and then continue, our KVL minus VDS minus minus RD ID and then plus VDD equal to 0. So we can find VDS equal to what? VDS equal to sorry, this one is minus. Okay. Okay. So minus VDS, this one, and then minus IDRD. Okay, this is correct one. Okay, so our VDS equal to VDD minus RD ID. Okay, ID value you have calculated, then you can find our VDS. Okay, okay, so VDD is 16. Okay, VDD is 16. Okay, so 16 over RD ID. So please find this value. Okay, so settle our VDS. And then VD is here. Okay, VD is here. Okay, this is VD. So VD equal to VDS when we apply this loop. Okay, minus VDS. Okay, plus VD equal to 0. So VD equal to VDS. Okay, settle this part. Okay, and then VG. VG is here. Okay, so VG equal to what? BGS, okay. So BG equal to BGS, okay. I remove this first. Same thing with the BJT. Okay, remove this first. Okay, so for the VG here, okay, VG here, we can drag here. This is our VG, positive, negative. Okay, we can apply using this loop, or you can apply using this loop. So let's say we apply using this loop. So we have what? Minus VG minus VGG equal to 0. Minus VG minus VGG equal to 0. Okay. So our VG equal to, okay, minus VG equal to VGG. And then this one move here. Okay, so VG equal to minus VGG. Okay, alright, and then settle. Okay, VS is here. Okay, VS. So VS, because this one is ground. Okay, this one is ground. So VS equal to 0 volt. Okay, so settle. So this how we do DC analysis, okay, for fixed bias JFET, okay, only for fixed bias JFET by using mathematical approach, okay, mathematical approach, okay, alright, okay. Next, you can using graphical approach, okay, to find the ID, and then all of this parameter you can use the same thing, okay. You can use the same thing. Okay, for example, okay, I remove this one. Okay, let's say we going to use graphical approach. Okay, you have to draw transfer characteristic ID. And then this one is our VGS, kan? Okay. Sorry, BP, not VGS. Okay. This one is BP. Okay. So you have to find this one, okay? Okay, this is by using the table. This table. Okay, this one we have learned, okay? Please refer to our previous video. Okay, I don't want to explain here again. Okay, so we have what? We have VGS here, we have ID here, so we have this, all this point, and then we have to plot 1, 2, 3, and 4, okay, and then you got the transfer characteristics, okay, by using this shorthand method, and then you found the VGS value. VGS equal to minus VGG, okay, minus 2 here, so you can draw the vertical line, okay, draw the vertical line, and then find the intersection here, and then this is our ID, okay, this is by using a graphical approach, okay, by using graphical approach, okay, okay, this one is by using graphical approach. So after you got the ID, okay, you just follow all this thing, okay, the same thing, okay, to find the BDS, okay, to find the VD, to find the BG, to find the VS on, and so on, okay. The key parameter is find ID first, so you can find all the all the value. Okay, that you that the question need you to find. All right. Okay, so hopefully you got okay some concept okay for our first fit wire circuit, okay, our first FET biasing circuits, okay, which is the fit bias biasing configuration circuits, okay, how to do the DC analysis, okay, that we have two approach, okay, again, and then the first one is mathematical approach. Okay, you have to find the ID by using the formula, okay. Remember, you have to remember the formula ID equal to IDSS 1 minus BGS over BP power of 2. And then the second method, you can use a graphical approach, and then by using a shorthand method, and then you have to draw the table, and then you draw the transfer characteristic curve, then you find the BGS value, and then you draw the vertical line, find the intersection there, then you can find the ID, and then after that, using KVL everything, you can find the all the voltage and current. Alright, okay, I want to stop here. So we will meet again on the next video. Hopefully you can spend your time to study this first before we go further on the next JFET biasing circuits, okay, safe bias and voltage divided bias to do the DC analysis. Okay, so thank you, enjoy watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe, okay, my YouTube channel. Okay, assalamualaikum, bye.